Is it right that you first decided you wanted to act when you were how very young? Was it four
about
or seven?
About seven.
Yeah. Because you picked up one of your mother's exotic dresses and held it up. Tell us what happened.
Well, it was a beautiful dress, I remember. It was red chiffon. And I put it on, of course. I mean, everything drooped and it folded to the floor. But I remember looking at myself in the mirror. And it was like one of those film wipes where everything goes sort of soft focus. It's like kind of groove. And I thought, yum, this is it.
Yes.
This is going to be what I want to do.
That's quite honest, because you actually saw yourself, this vision in red, and you thought, I want to dress up. I want to spend my life dressing up and playing other women.
That is, of course, the child's view of what acting is about. As you get older, you understand that it is, of course, much more difficult and much more complicated.
It's funny, it's a complete reverse of, you know, the actor Rupert Everett. His experience, he looked at himself in a mirror wearing his, I think, his elder sister's dress and burst into tears because he realised he could never be an actor.
That was the character in his novel.
It's also him, loosely based on himself. So you've also said, well, no one knows whether these quotes are absolutely true or not, but you said that you felt that the good fairy delivered ambition to your crib, which is a nice thing to say.
Yes.
It's unusual, you know, for actors and actresses to admit to that, to admit to ambition. Are you exceptionally ambitious? I mean, do you strive and strive?
I strive and strive. My striving is to be better. And I was jolly lucky to do The Avengers when I did it, but before that I'd done quite a lot of Shakespeare. So I was sort of on my way, as 'twere. I mean, I was sort of known as an up-and-coming classical actress.
Yeah.
And then I did The Avengers and it sort of catapulted me into the worldwide recognition. So the recognition, in a way, was there from quite early on.
But with that classical start, did you worry about doing The Avengers at all? Was there a moment when you thought, I'll stay on the stage, I won't move into popular television?
No, there wasn't a moment, but I had a certain amount of criticism from the classical
side. I bet you did.
Snobbery. Nowadays, people, thank God, move between the classics and doing sitcoms and films and all the rest of it. In those days, it was not considered the done thing at all, so they were a bit sniffy about it.
You very bravely, you put out a book, didn't you, which contained a lot of reviews and things about you.
Not just about me, but about people's bad reviews.
About people's bad reviews. Do bad reviews hurt you?
Of course they hurt everybody. Mm. But this book was an attempt at catharsis. If the review is really, it has to be funny.
Yeah.
I mean, you have to be able to quote it and to be able to laugh about it. And so I asked all the actors and actresses for their worst reviews and put it into a book. And the proceeds of the book went to the Denville Hall for Actors and a theatre for young children. So I wasn't sort of making money out of my fellow actors.
What was the
bad reviews?
Something about
my bad reviews.
Yes, sorry, we had to ask.
No, I don't mind quoting it at all. Because, I mean, it gave me, oh God, I read it. It was in New York. And I was doing Abelard and Eloise, and I had to do this nude scene in Abelard and Eloise, which was, of course, artistically lit, and hopefully nobody saw anything, because it was deeply uncomfortable, and it was stupid anyway. But the review said, Diana Rigg is built like a brick mausoleum with insufficient flying buttresses. And I mean, it's incredibly funny, but if you read it about yourself, the following day, going to the theatre, I sort of didn't even dare walk on the pavement. I sort of dodged into doorway. And I prayed that nobody in the theatre had read it. Of course they all had. And they all said, you know, hi, Di. And their eyes shifted immediately to my boobs, you know, the insufficient flying buttresses.
That's all we've got time for today, but join us again soon for more celebrity exclusives.